the challenge for this film is because it's in English, which is not my language. And like all through the years, we've seen a lot of films made about Chinese from foreign directors, and sometimes it looks very embarrassing. And because a lot of these Chinese characters has been distorted, and it's too exotic. So I always want to make a film in a different language, but I don't want to avoid this problems. When I'm working on this film, I always ask Nora, Jude, and all the crew sometimes some questions which they think, well, it's kind of silly, but I have to make sure. Because a kiss means difference in Chinese or in Chinese characters, or to a Western characters is quite different.
It was really amazing, just visually, the stuff he captured in the American landscape. It's beautiful. We shot in the desert, stuff like that that he really highlighted. I really enjoyed personally.
You really did go to work some days not knowing what was going to happen, and that doesn't become scary. That suddenly becomes very challenging and very exciting, and you know that whatever happens, it's going to be true, and it's going to be creative, and it's going to be right eventually, you know? So you also feel, you know, film is about collaboration. Everyone's there to make the end product look and sound and feel as good as possible. And in this way, without the kind of more rigid guidelines, everyone felt like they were putting in. And it was an incredibly fulfilling experience on that level.
I was not planning on making any kind of acting debut. And he knocked on my door, and I, out of the blue, I just thought, okay, well, I'm on tour, and I'm not an actress, so whatever. And then I got off tour, and I finally watched one of his films for the first time. I watched In the Mood for Love, and I thought, wow, that's just the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. And I thought, well, let's have lunch. Maybe he wants some music. And he says, you want to be in a movie? And I say, okay. You're amazing. So I just, for some reason, had a blind trust. Well, not blind, because I thought his filmmaking was amazing, but I just kind of jumped in and said, well, we'll figure it out later, I guess.
She always asked me, do I have to act? I said, don't act, be yourself. And then I said, now you have to act, because you are going to cry. And she said, okay, and give me a few minutes. And then we rolled the camera, and she cried. And then after that, I said, well, it's great. And she said, do you want one more? I said, no, this girl is going to be an actress, you know.
As soon as I heard the cast list, I went, oh my gosh, I'm really nervous. And it all became more real. And I was very, very nervous. And then the first day I was alone, I was very nervous. But then the second day of shooting was with Jude, and I didn't really know him. And I was so nervous, but I just decided, okay, I'm going to sink or swim, and nerves are going to bog me down. So I just kind of pushed it out of my mind as best I could.
Well, I remember we were into the film by about 4 or 5 days, and I really felt I was getting a sense of this peaceful, calm guy. And then Kar-Wai had this idea of this scene where I beat these guys up, and it seemed so different to the bloke I thought I was kind of creating. But suddenly, it also threw in the idea that, you know, people respond in moments as opposed to planning their life. You know, we are impulsive animals, and so suddenly that sort of took the character on a whole different tack.
Thank you.
I love the city. It was really different for me and very exciting, and it was just a really, I learned a lot. It was a big learning experience. The kiss, oh, well, it took a long time to shoot, but I think it turned out really well. I just made a lot of good friends, and everybody was so nice to me. I met so many people. That was the best part for me.
It's wonderful to have Nora to be in this film, and she's a great artist and also a very beautiful person, and I'm very happy to be able to work with her.
Notre ami cinéaste, Monsieur Wong Kar-Wai.
Thank you.